Hi students, this is Satish Kumar. In this video lecture, I am going to present the electromagnetic wave equations in various mediums. First, I would like to start with the Maxwell's equations in time-varying fields. Let us see them. Maxwell's equations. In time-varying fields. First, if you look at the first Maxwell equation, divergence of electric flux density is equal to rho v, which is volume charge density. This is the Maxwell equation which we get from Gauss law in electric field. And second equation is del dot B is equal to zero. And this is also obtained from Gauss law only, but this is in magnetic field. This is in magnetic field. And the third Maxwell equation that we get is curl of magnetic field intensity is equal to J vector plus dou D by dou T. This is a Maxwell equation which we get from Ampere's circuital law. Ampere's circuital law. And the fourth Maxwell equation that we get is curl of E will be is equal to minus dou B by dou T. This we get it from Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. Faraday's law. So once we get these four Maxwell's equations, which are in time varying fields, by using these equations, we can able to generate the electromagnetic wave equations. Okay, the Maxwell said this, that by using these four equations, particularly these two equations will be used to get the electromagnetic wave equations, but we will be using these equations, okay, in support of these two, okay? So Maxwell said that by using these four equations, we can able to get the electromagnetic wave equations in various fields. And those equations will be used in the principle of antenna. Okay, the basic principle that we use in antenna is how to generate the electromagnetic waves. Okay, now let us try to see the various media. Why we are seeing those media? Because these Maxwell's equations will be basically we are going to see in two types of medium. One is lossless medium, another is lossy medium. That's the reason. We will first try to see the different types of media. Or we can say different types of medium. We will be classifying basically these types of mediums into two types. One is lossless medium. Another is lossy medium. Lossy medium, right? So what is basically lossless medium is? The lossless medium we are going to get because when the conductivity sigma is zero. In any medium, if the conductivity sigma is zero, we call that medium is a lossless medium. In a medium, suppose if conductivity is having some value which is not equal to zero, when we call that medium is a lossy medium. Again, we classify these lossless mediums into two types. First one is free space, and second one is perfect dielectric. And these lossy medium, we are going to classify them into two types. One is a good dielectric, another is good conductor. Now we'll try to see the specifications of all this. For free space, it's very clear that there is no charge. When charge is zero, free space itself means there is no charge, vacuum. So rho v will be zero. When as the sigma is zero, I'll be writing that here. When sigma is zero, automatically J will be zero because J equal to sigma E. And for free space, it's very clear that mu r is one. So we can say mu is equal to mu naught. And epsilon is also equal to epsilon naught because epsilon r is also 1. We can say in free space mu r is 1 and epsilon r is 1. These are the specifications of free space. Now let us try to see the specifications of perfect dielectric material. In this also, volume, charge, density, rho v will be 0. Sigma, which is valid for this case also. As sigma is 0, J will be 0. Right, and the only difference between free space and perfect dielectric is mu r is greater than 1 here. That means you should consider the value of mu r here. That is mu equal to mu naught into mu r, and epsilon r also here is not equal to 1, it is greater than 1. There epsilon is also equal to epsilon naught into epsilon r. Now let us try to even see the condition for good dielectric where sigma is not equal to 0. Now the condition for good dielectric is the sigma by omega epsilon, if it is very, very lesser than 1, if it is very, very lesser than 1, in case, in other way, we can say that this as sigma is very, very lesser than omega epsilon, then we call that material is a good dielectric material. Simply speaking, for good dielectric material, sigma will be of the order of 10 power minus 1 to 10 power minus 4 moho per meter. That means it is not even 1. Okay, so if it is at least 10 power 2 or 10 power 3, we cannot call that is a good dielectric material. And what is the condition for good conductor? Sigma by omega epsilon is very, very greater than 1, or we can say sigma is very, very greater than omega epsilon. Sigma generally for the good conducting materials is of the order of 10 power 7 moho per meter. We'll try to see the different values of the conductivity for different good conducting materials like copper, silver, and gold, aluminium. Several materials will be having the conductivity values. The conductivity of copper will be generally of the order of 5.7 or 5.8 into 10 power 7, and for silver it is 6.1 into 10 power 7. For all the other materials also, it will be of the order of 10 power 7. The value that we get here may be slightly changes, but the order is generally of the order 10 power 7 for various materials. So this is basically the different types of medium in which we are going to see the electromagnetic wave equation. So in this, electromagnetic wave equations will be same for these two materials. That means we are going to write the electromagnetic waves for these two materials. We'll have a different electromagnetic wave equations for this lossless medium, or simply we can call it as electromagnetic wave equations in free space, and also we'll have another set of electromagnetic wave equations for this lossy medium, which we also call it as conducting medium, because here sigma is not equal to zero, we call this is a conducting medium. So we'll have two different types of electromagnetic wave equations. One is in lossless medium or free space, or we can say perfect dielectrics also, and another is the electromagnetic wave equations in conducting medium. First, we'll try to see the electromagnetic wave equations. The electromagnetic wave equations in free space or lossless medium. Okay, both are same. Or lossless medium. Here also there will be two cases. If you want the expression of electromagnetic wave equation in terms of E, and you will also get the electromagnetic wave equations in terms of H. But I am going to find out, let's say, the electromagnetic wave equations purely in terms of E. We can't get the electromagnetic wave equation both in terms of E and H at a time. We have to find out them individually. Suppose if you want to find out the electromagnetic wave equation in terms of E, what we should do is we should start with the Maxwell equation, which is having the curl with the electric field intensity E. So if you want the electromagnetic wave equation in terms of E, we should start with the Maxwell equation which we got from Faraday's law. That is, we know that simply del cross E is equal to minus dou B by dou T. Call this is equation number one. And as it is in free space, it's very clear that B is equal to mu naught into H, because mu naught is the permeability in free space, where mu naught is equal to 4 pi into 10 power minus 7 Henry per meter. We should substitute that there, which we will be getting is del cross E is equal to minus mu naught into dou h by dou t. Call this is second equation. Now what you should do is, because we want the electromagnetic wave equation, this is a first order differential equation that we get when we expand this del cross E, but we don't want a first order differential equation, we always require a second order differential equation. Okay, there will be two, three ways to get the second order differential equation, but the easier way is to take curl on both sides. Okay, or simply we can say take curl on both sides. When you take curl on both sides, what here you will be getting is del cross E is equal to minus mu naught, you bring it out, and del cross dou H by dou T. Okay? But we have a vector triple product, which is like A cross of B cross C. Then what you will be getting for this del cross E, you have to use back cab rule here. That is, here, if this is like A cross of B cross C, then if you use this back cab rule, what you will be getting is B into, that means this del into A dot C, that is A vector dot C vector is del dot E vector. del dot E vector minus C into means that is E into A dot B is del square. Everybody should remember this, del cross of E. Okay, this is a simple vector triple product which we will generally see in vector analysis. Now if you use this and write that here, which is del into del dot E minus del square E will be equal to minus mu naught dou by dou t. Also we can bring it out because it's a time differentiation, partial differentiation, and what is left is simply del cross H. But this del cross H is another Maxwell equation where we know that this del cross H is equal to J plus dou D by dou T. But in free space, it's very clear that as J is equal to sigma E and sigma is zero, so this will become simply zero. So this term won't be present in del cross H. So what we'll be doing is del into del dot E minus del square of E will be equal to minus mu naught into dou by dou t of that del cross H will be simply dou d by dou t. We'll try to expand this later, but we'll try to simplify what is this del into del dot E. What is this del dot E will be? This del dot E will be getting one of the other Maxwell equations. As I told you, we will use all four Maxwell's equations here. That is, this del dot D is equal to rho V. We'll try to use that. So we'll try to take that del dot D is equal to rho V. But as we are doing this entire derivation in free space, rho V is zero. Since free space, rho V is zero. And this D can be written as epsilon naught E. Okay, so del dot of epsilon naught, as it is a constant which is in a linear medium, because free space is a linear medium, we can bring that out, is equal to zero. Therefore del dot E will be equal to zero in free space. Okay, so we can even call this E is solenoidal vector, because divergence of this vector is equal to zero, but that is not necessary here. I'm just telling you. So if this is zero, then zero minus of del square E will be equal to this D can be here written as same thing, epsilon naught E. That epsilon naught also you can bring that out because it's a constant, and dou by dou T of dou E by dou T will be left. Now this is minus and this is also minus, just cancel it. So what you will be getting is del square E is equal to mu naught epsilon naught into dou by dou T of dou E by dou T will be, it's a second order, dou square E by dou T square. This is your electromagnetic wave equation in terms of E, where the del square can be expanded as dou square by dou x square plus dou square by dou y square plus dou square by dou z square in rectangular coordinate system. Okay, and this is a second order differential equation. We need to find out the solution to understand the electromagnetic wave characteristics. In a similar way, we need to even get the electromagnetic wave equation in terms of H. So what we'll be getting in terms of H is the same thing, but with a small change. In place of E, we'll be getting simply H. That is, del square H is equal to mu naught epsilon naught into dou square H by dou T square. This is a very simple equation which we will be getting like this. Both are exactly same, and we need to find out the solutions to understand the characteristics of electromagnetic wave equations. But to get this del square H equal to mu naught epsilon naught into dou square H by dou T square, we have to use the Maxwell equation del cross H is equal to J plus dou D by dou T, but J will be 0 in free space, dou D by dou T, and you have to take the curl on both sides again, and you will get this particular equation. Okay, thank you very much. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel.